Downtown in Tivoli. It's a song about a small town, Tivoli, and maybe my experience there. And I didn't grow up there. My brother lived there way back when, and I would visit him. I actually visited him in Millbrook, another town. Millbrook, I think, was, I can't even remember downtown Millbrook, but I remember downtown Tivoli. And it was kind of near Rhinebeck on the, I want to say upstate New York, I don't know what that means. It was south of Albany, but it was somewhere in between. And that area was just some really scenic along the Hudson. I mean, the Hudson is an amazing river, and the Hudson flows by it. And a lot of these towns got gentrified. Rhinebeck, they just became art enclaves and real trendy. And I think Rhinebeck was the big one. But Tivoli was kind of on the outskirts of that. And my brother befriended the proprietor of a restaurant, Pongo. And he, I don't know the circumstances on how they met, but he was then renting a room from her. And she was an entrepreneur slash, you know, obviously a chef, but really an artist. I mean, she just was super smart and just kind of had knew how to turn, you know, had a real knack, that entrepreneurial knack. I don't even know how to explain it. And I didn't really know her that well, but it was, I would arrive out of town from Cape Cod and I got to know some of the different people and a snapshot of that place. Tivoli was different than Rhinebeck. It hadn't really gentrified yet, so it was kind of walking back into time, and maybe the old guard was still there, present. Whatever bound the community together before had kind of changed, and Valerie was a pioneer. That's what she was, and she saw Tivoli as the next Rhinebeck, and she wanted to get in early. She wanted to lead that charge, so she put her restaurant there, Pongo. And Pongo was just an incredible energy to it. I mean, you get the best food there, but it was just stimulating, one of these kind of cafes. But you go there for, I think it was open all the time of day. I don't know how people run restaurants. It's an amazing amount of work that goes into it, or an incredible amount of work. And you got to know what you're doing in terms of delivering a good product, managing staff. And Valerie just had a real knack for that. I think the song is just a picture window into small town life, and from really the perspective of an outsider going to visit his brother. And there's a snapshot of some of the different people. Annie maybe was the old guard. Valerie was the new guard. She was the proprietor of the restaurant. And then Wendolyn, and I'm even featured in there. I'm Buzz. That was a name from a forgotten, from long ago. So, and just different characters. I mean, and some of the characters aren't from the town, but were just in my mind as I was pulling into that town that night. And I remember then visiting my brother and us going down to New York City, or us climbing up to the top of one of the Catskill Mountains and looking down. He'd just say, you see down there, that's where Tivoli is, or that's where, you know, the Hudson is, or, and that conversation might end. Let's go down and let's, we'd go for a hike and let's go to Pongo. So it's a song about my brother as much as anything, but it's really a song about small town, the small town of Tivoli. And it's an ode to the small town and all the people that make those work. Whether it's the old guard or the new guard moving in. And most of all, it's a song about Pongo and Valerie. And lost touch. She was a person I did not know all that well. I mean, at the moment, we had great conversations. But, you know, that's how it is in life. You kind of move on and you wonder where those people are now, what they're doing. And, maybe this song is my way of saying hello, and maybe I should get on a song a long time ago. Anyway, all things with time. In good time.